Example two, this is a disjunction. The word or is involved with the disjunction. Or means that we graph both inequalities individually on the same number line with the given domain. All right. We're looking for, again, just x. So if it's just x, you're ready to go. So this one right here is ready to go as is. So x is greater than or equal to 3 is perfect. Ready to go. The second graph, x is less than or equal to negative 2, is also ready to go. As long as you have x isolated, x all by itself, inequality symbol, you're ready to go. Okay, once again, when I'm graphing this, I'm looking at the domain as a set of integers. So I'm only graphing integers. X is greater than or equal to 3 means I start at 3 and go to the right forever. And negative 2 means start at negative 2, go to the left forever. I'm going to need to make sure these numbers both show up on here. So let's go negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So if I start with x is greater than or equal to positive 3. Three is an integer, and x equals 3 is correct. All right, greater than 3 would be 4, which is an integer, 5, which is an integer, and 6, which is an integer. And then I want to fill in the arrow to show that I continue on. So if I were to pull this out more, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on, are all getting graphed also. And all those are from this graph, that equation. Then, with or, it just means, again, that if this is true or this is true, I'm going to graph it. So x less than or equal to negative 2 means I have a closed circle at negative 2 because it equals negative 2, and negative 2 is an integer. And less than goes to the left, so I'm going to fill in negative 3, negative 4, only graphing integers, and I make the arrow bold to show that as I continue on that direction forever and ever and ever, every dot gets marked also. So the only integers that are false would be negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Those are the only four numbers that would make neither of these two true. This is that, graph them both in the same number line whenever you see the word or.